I'm just wondering if the Goth wardrobe always is black, or is it anything else? What do you think? Are your wardrobe closet just plain black, or do you have anything that is not that? I can confess, mine is not completely black. It used to be there for a while, but I have, through all these years, going up and down when it comes to including colors too, but the base will always be black. Do you want to take a look how it can look inside my closets? I'm gonna show you. So this is my closets. This is two of them. Not directly gothic like in colors, but you don't have to have everything black when you're black dressed. And they are actually from IKEA. The Swedish people say that. I guess the most people abroad say it IKEA. And on top, they even have some boxes with it, other things, with shoes and dress, medieval dress and that type of things. But the left one is my main one I usually use clothes from. And look, yeah, you can tell it's a bit black, but it's not completely black because you can actually see some colors showing in here. And this is actually my Nightmare Before Christmas dress that I love to wear sometimes, but the most things are plain black. And as you can see, people that know can recognize Killstar, they can recognize other stuff from EMP, plus I got Eva from Restyle and the other type of brands, and sometimes even clothing that I have for years. This is actually from another ordinary shops. So you can see, not completely black, but the most are. So we close this one. And what do you think I have in the right one? Dust people are even more colorful. Because this is clothes that I don't wear that often. Excuse me, that is my working clothes in the bottom, the spare ones. But like you see, I have some color type of things, and actually a lot of things are even handmade by me. So like this blue corset, and not that one, but this one is made by me. This skirt is, for example. I have some PVC stuff I have made myself, and this one too, with an anchor. All are very. And here I got the white shirt I usually use sometimes. A little other stuff, but here is at least a little more thing. It's a little crowded, so it's a little hard to actually show exactly what I have. But this is the result. No, a goth don't need to have everything black. So how is your closet look like? Tell me. I thought I should give you some example of things I actually done myself to prove that they don't have to be that expensive to have gothic things that looks a little more fun or more your own style for the moment. And when I was younger, I actually mixed different type of styles depending on my mood and the period in my life. So I've gone through a lot of different ones. It's not everything I have. This is most of the things I still have and still can wear. Other things I have thrown, given away, or even sold. So now I'm gonna go through some of the things. It's mainly one shirt, corsets, and lots of skirts, of course. I don't know how it. I always end up with a lot of skirts, but no tops. So I'm a little impossible. Here I got, for an example, a black and white corset. And here I got a nice little skirt that goes well together with that. But I actually had a skirt that was made for that corset, but I think I sold it. This is another one I did, one of the first one. It can be the first one I made, I'm not sure. But I like the fabrics, like you can see it, a little glimmering effect in it. And I don't have any fitting for that. Then I have this PVC skirt. And I actually made some of them. I got some decent PVC during the time. And I'm a little sucker for those things that you can put on belts or something, chains. Another example on a PVC skirt. And of course, I often slaughter things I find. This was probably from a necklace and I can't wear it, so it ended up on a skirt. And this time it's this skirt. It's actually a very simple skirt to do. It's like a big circle. You just make room enough for the elastic to fit and go over your hips, but still sit where you should. And then you just do whatever you want in whatever fabrics, put up lace, added arterials. This is a blue skirt, the same type like the PVC in black. And you can see it's bits in PVC. And this fabulous Chinese thing. And still you see those details, I'm crazy about that. Of course I did a matching corset to that too. And then we go up. Here we got this lovely thing here, and some people might recognize this one with the ink. And it's actually been made by two different layers, so I had a very shimmery, it's not PVC, but it's something in between ordinary fabrics and PVC, so it feels a little plastic like and it's actually like fishnet type of fabric over. And I did this ank myself. It's the same type of circles. And here is another PVC one. It's the same type of skirt, but here with other types of things. And actually those things came from the things used for candles. You know, I take everything I can find, the suits, and I probably had a purple thing to go with it. It looks more pinkish in this color because it's been bleached, but it was actually a very light purple. And finally we have this shirt. I used to have more shirts in other colors, but this is the only one I actually still have, and it goes very well with my Victorian skirts. So that's all I show for this time, and I hope I can give some people an idea that you can actually do your own things, even a corset. And here you can see a sample of three corsets. So it takes some time, but it's well worth it. By the way, if you like this video, give it a like. If you didn't, dislike. And if you haven't, subscribe. Everything to help my channel to grow. Thanks for following and be safe. Love you all. Bye.